Okay, so in my setting, my homebrew setting, the next obvious race group, probably, especially since it's Tolkienish type related, is the elves, right? And again, since I'm using Rollmaster 2 and some of the companions, and there's some expanded lists of available races, though these might have been in the original one, I can't remember, like the base book. And again, they probably have, like, fans of Tolkien can look at their descriptions and probably point back to which people groups they were talking about, right? Like, I think I'm not gonna fail to come up with those names again. Forget it. So the three generically titled elf-like sub-races or races, if you will, are high elves, fair elves, and wood elves. Now, with the elves, I took a slight opportunity to give the anime fans a little bit of a place to play. Like, I could kind of imagine people saying, "Well, I want to play a blah 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 blah," right? Like coming up with their own creations rather than looking at the setting and seeing what's available. Small pet peeve of mine. And the way the small nod, honestly, it is just a small nod that I did for that was basically, you could have some, average blonde, brunette, whatnot. I'm gonna stop shaking in case that makes someone sick. The, normal type, realistic hair colors. But I also put in some crazy hair colors, like the. If I remember correctly, so the high elves could have some metallic hair colors, such as bronze and copper and silver or gold. I think they had all the darker metals. I don't remember this much anymore. Whereas the fair elves could have lighter metals, right? Like silver and gold. I'm seeing a jump in some of my recording. Hopefully that's not coming through. Though, as long as the audio comes through, that's fine. And the wood elves are where the real anime fans could choose some colors. Like they had the bright greens and the bright purples and the bright, yellow or reds or blues. They had the Crayola box colors, right? But in a shiny, pretty way. I did not pick Immortality. I don't dig that as a playable race kind of thing. I'm not sure if I dig that in settings at all. But I have no problem with long lived, right? So the shortest of the three. Well, let's start at the middle, right? Let's talk about the high elves. The high elves are the ones that are kind of in the middle. They are the equivalent in the elf world to high man, right? Tall with stature, natural leaders kind of thing, and they lived, I think, to the 400 to 500 kind of range, and they were a little bit more militaristic than their cousins, culturally speaking. Yeah, aside from that, that's pretty much the end of that description. If you go up, so to speak. Oh, and I also took, the Tolkien elf idea, right? So elves are also tall and tend to be slender, right? So the high elves were the peoples who, a short elf would be, 5'8", 5'9", something like that, right? And that could get up to 6 to 6.5 pretty easily, right? The fair elves had more delicate constitutions, more delicate bodies, but were more predisposed through their stat bonuses for the magicals. That didn't mean they didn't make armies and they didn't get, couldn't whoop your butt, but that was more their predisposition, right? Or at least they were more academic and more spiritual. And all the three different elves do have their own different religions. I don't actually remember what my religious ideas were for the either the high elves or the fair elves. I don't remember which one. they were. But the fair elves were fairer, and they got stupid tall. They got up to 7 feet tall. And I don't think they got any shorter than, you know, like 5'10". That would be a pretty short fair elf. And the wood elves were the... Oh, and also the fair elves were the longest living of them. Like, they would do... What did I say for the high elves? Did I say 5 to 6 or did I say 4 to 5? Basically, the fair elves were another 100 or 150 past that. And the wood elves were on the shorter edge. They were on the shorter end of the height spectrum. They did 5.5 to 6 feet or so, and they had a shorter lifespan. So they were more 300 to 400, I think it was, or 350 to 450. And I do remember that they had a religious belief that the gods, they had a pantheon, but it was a very nondescript pantheon. And the idea for them was they saw chaos in the world, and they believed that that was because the gods themselves didn't really know their place, didn't really have defined roles, right? Like in other pantheons, there's the god of this and the god of that. And the pantheon, basically their pantheon reflected the randomness and chaos that they saw in the world, right? Like they thought that the world was chaotic because the deities behind the world are kind of chaotic. Not chaotic in a moral sense, but just chaotic in a place and function sense. And they were the shortest living. I did have them... Well, I'm just going to keep this to the races, and I'll try to talk about the nations later, especially since this is about to hit 7 minutes. Bye!